Hello everyone, welcome back. The topic for discussion today is the important cases that have been decided by the courts of India during this week. So the first case is Triveni Kotkani and others versus Air India Limited, also known as the rate of conversion case. This case was pertaining to the death of Mahendra Kotkani, who earned in Arab Emirates dirham. Here, the claim was made by the widow and children of the deceased before the National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission. The claim was pertaining to the conversion of currency from foreign currency. Dissatisfied with the compensation awarded by the National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission in Indian rupees, they appealed to the Supreme Court on various grounds. So, the first ground was that the National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission should have applied the rate of conversion, which was prevailing as on the date of judgment and not as on the date of the claim. As per the accident compensation income to be assessed based on employee's entitlement without deduction of allowances before the Supreme Court, petitioner claimed. Also, here the petitioner pointed out that for these cases the precedent should be followed. But the court had applied the rate of conversion as applicable on the date of judgment. Taking up the first case in Farsol versus ONGC, a major part of the claim for payment was in French France. The court further took note of the fact that the party entitled to receive the payment was a foreign party. After consideration of the English authorities on the matter, it was held that the date of conversion should be the date of judgment. Also, in Renu Sagar Power Company Limited versus General Company Limited, a contract was executed between a company incorporated in India and a company incorporated in the US. Under the terms of the contract, the amount to be paid was expressed in US dollar. The court noted that both the money of account and money of payment were in terms of US dollar. Hence, both in Farsol versus Renu Sagar, the recipients of payments were foreign parties. Moreover, the terms of contract entered into by the parties stipulated that the payments were to be made in the terms of foreign currency. Further, in United India Insurance Company Limited versus Kantika Color Lab, the respondent had obtained an insurance policy to cover the risk of transit of a film processor and printer processor from Mumbai to Haridwar. The printer suffered extensive damage during the transit. The respondent sought damages from the insurer. After coming to the conclusion that the printer could not be repaired, the court was to determine the cost of replacement. In determining it, a two-bench judge held that the cost should be ascertained as the cost of replacement, along with customs duty component at the rupee equivalent of exchange rate prevalent on the date of judgment. Also, in Balram Prasad versus Kunal Shah, the court had to determine the compensation to be awarded to the husband of the deceased as a result of the death of his wife due to medical negligence in India. The claimant as well as the deceased were non-resident Indians. The two-judge bench of this court accepted the plea that the claimant and the value of rupee had depreciated since the commencement of legal proceedings, and in computing the compensation regarded the current value of a rupee of stable rate of rupees 55 per US dollar. Distinguishing these judgments, the Supreme Court observed, in the bench comprising of Justice D.Y. Chandrachud and Ajay Rastogi, noted that the facts of the instant case were distinguished from the judgments which had been cited earlier. The facts in the context of which the above judgments were rendered are distinguished from the present case. The money is not being repatriated abroad. The claimants are Indian residents. The claimant contains a claim for payment in Indian rupees. They would be receiving the payment in Indian rupees. Moreover, The court is allowing the claim for interest in terms of the decision of National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission. Ultimately, the bench awarded a compensation of 7,64,29,437 rupees. The next case that we are dealing is MD Rustam Alam versus State of Jharkhand. The facts of the case are such that here the petitioners contended that the court had issued non-bailable warrant of arrest in their names without receipt of the service report of bailable warrant of arrest. Similarly, they submitted without being any service report of non-bailable warrant of arrest. Process under Section 82 of CRPC had been issued or declaring the petitioners as proclaimed offenders. Further, without any service of process under Section 82 of CRPC, attachment order in terms of Section 83 had been issued. Finding merit in the case, the High Court of Jharkhand quashed the impunct order for having been passed without due application of mind. In terms of similar cases like the Raghuvansh Divachand Bhasin versus State of Maharashtra, here the case liberty is being curtailed by issuance of non-bailable warrant of arrest. Thus, the court has to record his satisfaction that the conditions laid down in the law for issuing warrant of arrest has been fulfilled and the procedure has been complied with. This satisfaction of court should be reflected in the order itself to be gathered from the record. Then only warrant of arrest can be issued. Also, the court should have a prima facie satisfied that the person accused of committing a non-bailable offence is also evading his arrest. There has to be a material before the court to reach at the aforesaid conclusion. Also, in the case of Auto Cars versus Trimurti Cargo Movers Private Limited, whereby the Supreme Court had held that the non-compliance with the statutory requirements regarding mentioning of the specific day, date, year and time would amount to material infirmity rendering summons as well as their services bad in law. Also, in terms of Supreme Court's verdict in State of Maharashtra, in State of Madhya Pradesh versus Pradeep Sharma, here the court held when the relief of anticipatory bail is curtailed as a consequence of an order passed under Section 82 of the court declaring a person absconder, the said order cannot be passed in mechanical manner without recording satisfaction and reasons, nor the same be passed without following the procedure as laid down in the court. In view of the above circumstances and consequences, one has to face the court has to be very cautious while issuing an order under Section 82 of the CRPC. Here, Section 82 of the CRPC declares a procedure for declaring a person as proclaimed offender and prescribes that only after the court is satisfied that the person is absconding or is concealing and is not possible to arrest him, the court should issue proclamation requiring accused to appear on a specified date on specified time not less than 30 days from the date of publication of such proclamation. Also, Section 83 of the CRPC provides that the court which is issuing proclamation under Section 82 of the court for reasons to be recorded in writing may order for attachment of movable or immovable properties. A statement of reason is however exempt in both case of process, that is proclamation under 82 of the court and attachment in terms of order Section 83 of the court are issued simultaneously. In the present case, the Jharkhand High Court subsequently issued and thus providing a statement as envisaged under 82 subsection 3 of CRPC, attachment orders under section 3 of the court cannot be issued. Also, the court observed when warrant of arrest was issued, the petitioners were neither escaped convicts nor proclaimed offenders. The petitioners had failed to appear before the court and they could, at best, fall in the third category, that is, an accused of non-bailable offence in the evading arrest. Thus, the court has reiterated that non-bailable warrant of arrest and process, an order of attachment under the CRPC, cannot be issued in a mechanical manner, and the court has to record its satisfaction with regard to the prerequisites before passing such an order. Also, none of the provisions as envisaged in Section 73, 82, 83 of the CRPC has been complied with by the court. Non-compliance of the mandatory provisions of the law renders the impunct orders by which order issuing non-bailable warrant of arrest under Section 82 and attachment under Section 83 of the court have been passed are thus quashed and set aside. Thus, the matter was accordingly remitted to the court concerned to proceed afresh and pass fresh orders in accordance with the law after complying with the provisions as provided in the relevant sections of the court. Thus, we come to the end of this video, and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching my video.